is making. And actually, for those that haven't seen this book, Bill wrote this in 1978.
And I'll say it is available on Amazon.
Okay.
There are copies out there.
And it was called The Renaissance of Mark Twain's House, A Handbook for Restoration. And it was really an account of this extraordinary journey that Jared just described. At that time, in the early 70s, the science of restoration was just emerging as a concept. Prior to that time, it was a lot of guesswork and, you know, kind of taste, individualistic taste, as Jared referred to. Who's to say, because taste is relative and we don't really know anyway. Well, Jared and Bill and others proved that you could know, that you could do a kind of archaeological exactness with the analysis of the physical properties and the documentation and sometimes photographic records, and you could really, really get it right. And that was just emerging. So the Mark Twain House became kind of a nationally significant icon of essentially the professionalization of this science at a time when everybody was kind of, or many people were kind of curious about it. And I should just, this is a brief quote. The introduction to this book was written by Oliver Jensen. Some of you may know that name, but he literally was the Ken Burns of his generation, who through American Heritage magazine, which was the gold standard for popularization of history, he wrote the introduction to this book. And he talked about how it looked like the homeowner might, after they got done with this first phase of restoration, might have just turned the key and departed an hour ago. And then he says, I love this, he quotes Mark Twain himself in this wonderful introduction. He said, few things are harder to put up with than the annoyance of a good example. The achievement of the Mark Twain House is going to make things unbearable for a lot of people in the field of restoration. And I think that, you know, part of Bill's, no question that he had an obsessive attention to detail. He sweated the details. And for people that do that, that can be annoying to the rest of us because they're perfectionists. And it required that kind of perfectionism to get it right, and particularly to, and essentially with Jared and others, invent a new science of restoration.